Islands.
So guys, I made a video earlier in full HD actually, but what happened, somehow OBS just didn't encode it perfectly, and it just, even I uploaded the entire 1GB video to YouTube and just went bad. So I am going to make it again. So here it is. First of all, this notification when you start the game, this is dynamic notification. So you can keep, if anything changes or there are new notifications, you can keep an eye here. Now let's go into the game and I will talk about the changes I have done. There are many changes as asked by the testers. Many of the testers suggested a few changes, and there were two major bugs basically. One of them was every new player was getting stuck in the space station, and after a discussion with one of the testers named Matthew, I get to know it was true. So I will show that particular space specifically, and the new build is already uploading, so by the time you will see that video, you will already have that new build with new features, so the testers will have easy time for testing. So okay, so this thing, some players also suggested this and I also had in mind, but I did it now. Okay, I completed it. Basically now your username and password will be saved, so you don't have to input it again and again if game crashes or something like this happens. Going in. Alright. Okay. Now, this is another thing. Some players were complaining that we always spawn in space station, not where you were last. So, fixed it. Now, we spawn where you were last in the space. Okay, now a few things, a few changes. First of all, if you ever get stuck anywhere for the testing purposes, you can just press skip and just click that button once, and you will be basically moved to the space station. Press skip again, and here you are inside the space station. Okay. So, also guys, lot of people are players are complaining that we are a midget. No, we are not. We are actually 1 meter and 1.7 meters. That's around a 5'11" or 5'12", approximately 6 foot height. So we are not small. Actually, these models are bigger, and we bought them. So already used them this way, so for resizing them to a perfect fit it will take a lot of time, so it is an issue, will be fixed, but not now, maybe later. Okay, so there are some people and they are playing. All right so let me show you the place where they were falling off. So this is the place. This was the place where they were falling off. Now it's fixed and no more problems. You can just work as you were earlier. Now another thing, now when you press P, this player PDA opens, which have two features. This feature will always be there, and this button, this is actually a testing feature. Basically, you can open market anywhere, so you don't have to come to space station if you are an asteroid or something, just to test this feature. Okay, so it will be very easy to test. And another thing is, these are teleport locations. Now these are not hard coded. Actually, I made a base in the asteroid, and I put two teleport locations, teleport blocks there. So these are two blocks, and I will show them. Let me teleport to my base in the asteroid. All right. So this was the base I made yesterday. I just put two teleport beacons here. Let me put another one. So this teleport beacon, you can basically find it in the devices. Here it is. I already have them in the hotbar. So let me put one here. Okay. So what you can do, you can just use the interaction control and name it anything. Like I name it teleport 3. And guys, there is still an issue, I know. So I will just stop it. Just save it for now. Now open the PDA and you can see that this teleport location 2, where you can teleport anytime you want. Now the thing is that when you press T, time is basically slowed for you for some time. See? So if that happens somewhere while typing, just press T again and you will get out of this slow time. Okay, so you can see these new type of ships. These are special cargo ships used to carry mineral and resources. And the earlier video, that was not perfect. I made very elaborate attempt to describe it. Have to do it again. First let me talk about this thing there. What is that? That is a land beacon, basically. That can you put on land, on any type of terrain, basically, to mark things, basically. Like this rock has nice amount of resources, so I put one here. So let me put one here. Go to market. Here you can find most of the things that can be spawned on terrain. This is the beacon. Buy one. That in hotbar. Let me spawn it here. This one. Okay. This way you can mark any location, anywhere in space, for your own memory. And access this interaction panel and put any name, like set. One, save, and you can see ESET 1. Okay. Now let's open the PDA, teleport to our base, and so you can find this ship here in the market. Go here in the last tab. This is the Dello carrier. Also guys, all the names of these ships and items are temporary, so if you think of better sci-fi or space related name, you can suggest this name in the forums itself, and we will choose those who will, we will see fit, we will rename them here. So you can actually have your suggested name here. If you want, just suggest us. Go to the forums in the chit chat section. Okay, so I already spawned it, but for the sake of it, going to do it again. And don't get confused with that indicator. It does not match with the ship. And in the next release, this will be updated too. Okay. So the ship is here. This is the access control panel. And near it, here you can find the fuel tank. Fill it and it's ready. Let's go. mine some resources.
Ship ready.
Go to third person. Already. Hit the power on. Let's go. So I'm going to the same rock where I put the beacon. So beacons are used as indicators. There were some good resources. So I will show you how to use this particular ship for carrying resources from those asteroids to your base for further processing. I like this ship very much. It is very smooth, very smooth to fly and very agile. Let's stop here for once. Let us see if we have any resources here nearby. Do we? Can't see any. Where are those? Okay. Let's get there.
Ship ready.
So this is basically exploration part, hunting for resources. Okay, no resources on this rock. Let's go somewhere else. Okay, let's go there. Might find some there. Alright, found some. So I'm going to mine this one. Alright, so what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to position my ship so that the cargo hull of it just remains parallel to the resource. Little bit tilt and you will know why. Power off, get out by N, power off by Y, J by jetpack. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to come here and use this control panel near the cargo hull to basically start the attractor or the retractor, whatever you want to say it. Let's go to the resource, watch light and mine it. Guys, we do have drill. Okay, for the demonstration purposes, I am going to show it. However, in the release version, you have to grind basically to get the drill. Okay. You have to grind, you have to work hard to get those. These are the drill bits. So I'm going to replace okay, here's the drill. Going to use the drill now. Alright. So see how the attractor is working to get all the resources on the cargo bay. Yeah. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to switch off the machine and going to drag those resources on the cargo bay itself, because the idea is to keep those resources on the cargo bay. As long as these resources are touching the cargo bay, they will stay attached to the ship when we will fly the ship. So there are many more resources, but it's up to you to extract all of them. And let's use our spaceship. Ship ready. Let's go home. As you can see, the resources are attached. Let's go to our base. Because the idea is to work hard to get experience, and when you start playing, after a few hours you will basically get accustomed to all these things, and all these things will be very easy for you after that. It will not feel that much grindy. And we are going to add some features like resource scanners, better cargo hauling features in that ship itself. It's in the primary stage. We are working on it. The code is not finished for that. It's in the primary stage, so it's a little bit hard to work with it. We are thinking to make it even easier to carry cargo. So just bear with it for now. It is definitely going to be way better. So we are close to our base. We already have a processing unit there. Sorry. So I'm going to align this ship close to the machine. In the previous video, I used this ship. You can see that this one, I aligned it perfectly. A little bit of work is required. I know. Lot of ships here. Power off, get out, and the resources is fly. Yeah, this is a problem right now. We will fix it later releases, but these resources are way closer to our extracting unit than they could have been. You have to basically carry one resource at a time from these asteroids. Better to carry that in this ship. And you can just don't limit yourself to 4 or 5. Put more here. Right? So carry, at least you can carry 10 here, 10 or 20, depending on how you fix them. Okay? So let's first power on them. Again, attractor or retractor. Now, this has very small range. So you have to basically get these resources in the range. To grab these resources, you have to move your mouse pointer on the resource itself and keep holding F. This is how. Okay, go close and throw it, and the retractor will work rest. going to do that with all of them. It's fun basically, but definitely going to improve that. What I am thinking that to make something like you can put these blocks in space up to a certain distance, and each one of them will attract a resource and throw them to the another one. So it will be like a rail system. You just extract resource, throw towards your closest that block, and it will basically, your resources will travel through all your rail system you have made to your base directly. It's not easy to code, so it's just, you can say it's basically in a concept only. Later we are going to do that. Right now it's just in concept, early stage. Alright, so yeah, all of them are there. And if you get confused that when you press J, jetpack is not working, you have to go to the market basically and go to this one, this tab, and buy this one, Tylium fuel cell. These Tylium fuel cells are sorry, required for jetpack. Okay, also there were, okay, now there was also one thing that I have fixed. This one, this was when Macu suggested that this net was, there was some iron net that was not looking good, steel net. So I just put force field here, which looks way better than a metal thing. It's a force field basically. So now not an issue. It's around 22 minutes, so I'm cutting the video here. And in the next video, we will go into planet and spend few days there and few nights, because nights and planets are not easy to go by. Okay, see you later.